हेलो माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द एलिजाबेथन लिटरेचर और वी कैन से एलिजाबेथन पीरियड। इट स्टार्ट्स इन 1558 एंड इट एंड्स इन 1603। द इंग्लिश लिटरेरी रिनेसा द टर्म कंसिस्ट फ्रॉम एलिजाबेथन एज हैज फोर सबसेस्ट। द फर्स्ट इज द एलिजाबेथन एज, the second is Jacobean age, the third is Caroline age, and the last one is Commonwealth age. The Elizabethan literature saw a great flourishing literature, especially in drama, because literary style was lyrical at that time, or we can say that lyrical poetry was very much popular at this time. It is marked by strong natural spirit and patriotism and religious tolerance. Patriotism was for the Queen Elizabeth, because she was very popular among the countrymen. Romance was very much dominated in literature in the age, as we saw in Shakespeare's dramas like As You Like It. And this drama, this kind of themes, it was very much influenced by the Italian literature. Now we will talk about the writers of this period. Sir Philip Sidney, Sir Edmund Spenser, Roger Ascham, Rose Hooker, Christopher Marlowe, and the great William Shakespeare was the prolific writer of this Elizabethan period. Now we will focus on the literary forms of the Elizabethan period. So we all know and drama is very much popular at the time of Elizabethan period, because it was to develop a sense of appreciation to plays performance, because theater performance was very much popular among the people, and it was the habit of the people to attend the theater performance in the time of Elizabethan period. That's why drama was the most popular form of literature at the time of Elizabethan period, and we may also call it as the golden age, because in this Elizabethan period there was Shakespeare, Marlowe, Spenser, Kidd, and Jonson, who worked on poetry, and the drama that flourished by Shakespeare and Marlowe, it is still very much popular. It is evergreen drama that has been written in the time of Elizabethan period. So that's why we may call it as the golden age of Elizabethan period. Now we will talk about the Elizabethan tragedy. That mostly Elizabethan tragedy is applied to Shakespearean tragedy, because the hero of the tragedy always contribute to some way to this to him or to his downfall, and it results in tragedy. Tragedy is always somehow it is, or it may be the death of the hero or the death of some very important character of the drama. That's why it is called tragedy. It ends with sadness. The end is sadness, with full of mourning and all. That's why we call it tragedy. Now what is the importance of this age in our English literature? Because वी मे से दैट बर्थ ऑफ द थिएटर इन द वर्ल्ड. ब्रिटिश थिएटर इज कॉल्ड एज द फर्स्ट थिएटर इन द वर्ल्ड बिकॉज इट गिव्स न्यू आइडियाज. It gives new ideas and thinking to the world. So, the introduction of the printing press and inventions and discoveries were also there. That's why we call it as the age of Renaissance. Renaissance because it was the age of new era. It was age of new discoveries in science and it was the age of new inventions. That's why it is also called as the age of Renaissance. What type of tragedy in this age is that? It was domestic kind of tragedy. Second was tragicomedy. Means both the aspect of tragedy and comedy was there. And it is called... It is the time of unities, unities, and in tragedy there is hamartia, revenge tragedy, cathartic tragedy, heroic play. So these are the aspect of tragedy that it is Senecan tragedy. Revenge tragedy, catharsis, heroic play, all are the kind of tragedy. So I think this is clear till now for the Shakespearean period. Next part we will deal later in our another video. Thank you.